Hello friends, and welcome again to my channel Faisai. From the past 6th lecture we are studying about LS and JJ coupling, and this is the lecture number 7. And in this lecture we will study about the order of terms and fine structure levels. It is very important to find how we can arrange this these terms according to their relative energies. Okay, so the relative energies of the various terms and the levels which arise from a given configuration, these can be deduced from some basic rules, and these rules are given by Hund. Okay, so the rules for the order of terms and fine structure levels were given by Hund. These rules are, okay, the first rule. The rule number one is that the terms arising from equivalent electrons those with largest multiplicity will lie, okay, we know that the multiplicity is given by the formula, okay, and the s is actually the sum of the spin due to various electron. Okay, this is the rule number one. After stating all these rules, I will apply these rules to a we'll take some examples, and they will clarify you every single concept in it. Okay, the second rule is, if we have various terms with given multiplicity, for various terms with given multiplicity, those with largest L will lie lowest. Okay, so if we have some terms which have same multiplicity, then those with the largest L value, we have to put them in the lowest order. The rule number three. In rule number three, we have basically three rules. The first one is, suppose if we have equivalent electrons with less than half filled condition. If we have equivalent electrons, and those electrons have less than half filled configuration, then the level with the lowest J lie lowest, and this is called normal order. Why it is called normal order? Because normally we go from the lowest to highest energies, And in this particular rule, you can see that we are arranging according to the we are arranging the terms, we are arranging the actually terms, the fine structure components, the fine structure levels according to the increasing j. So that's why it is called the normal order. Rule number B, if we have equal electrons with more than half filled, more than half filled configuration, then the level with largest j lie lowest, and this is called inverted order. You see that we are arranging it as the largest j value will lie lowest, and the lowest j in the the upper position. That's why we have called this inverted order and the normal order. Okay. The rule number 3C. Okay. Now the lowest term arising from the half filled subshells are the S terms, are always S terms. Okay, are always S terms. Okay, the lowest term. Okay, the lowest term, the lowest term arising from the half filled subshell are always S term. Now what is half filled? Suppose we have P subshell. Now in the P subshell we have maximum of 6 electrons, and if it is half filled we have a P3 configuration. It is a half filled. In the first two rules we stated about more than half filled and less than half filled, and for half filled we have just so for P3, suppose we have 3 equivalent electrons, the ground state will always be a S term. For the ground state will be the S term. Okay. Now and these are extra stable, actually these are extra stable. Okay, so these terms are 2s 1 by 2, that is for half filled S, and then 2s 3 by 2, that is for half filled P subshell, 2s 5 by 2 for half filled SP, after FP we have D subshell, and so on. Okay, and so on. So these are the basic rules, and sorry I have made a mistake, here we have 4, because multiplicity changes for D cell, the multiplicity is 6. Now these are the rules that we should follow while arranging the fine structure levels. Now let us take an example. Suppose we have this example 1. Suppose we have 2p equivalent 2p electrons, and because let's say the n values are same and the l values you can see they are also same. In the lecture or so, we have actually find the from the terms for these equivalent electrons. Suppose we have a carbon atom. Now electron configuration of carbon atom is 1s2, then 2s2 and 2p2. So these are the valence electrons, which are also called the optically active electrons. Okay, and these are equivalent electrons because the value of n is same and value of l is also the same. For these equivalent electrons, the terms are, we have already found the terms, these terms in the lecture number 5. Okay. So we have these spectral terms. Now we have to arrange these spectral terms according to the increasing energies using these rules. Okay. Now let us see the and also we have to find which is the ground state. Okay. Now, the first rule is that the terms arising from equivalent electrons, those with largest multiplicity will lie lowest. Okay, you can see the p terms will have, they have the largest multiplicity, which is 3. Here the multiplicity is 1, here the multiplicity is 1. So these are the largest multiplicity. So we have to arrange this p first, and then s and then t. Okay. Now the second one. The second one says, for various terms with given multiplicity, those with largest l will lie low. Okay. Now we can see in these, suppose these three terms has a multiplicity of 3, but all of them has the same l values. Okay. All of them has the same l values. So we don't need to apply this rule. Okay. And in this term we just have a single term, and we just have a single term. Okay. Now the rule number 3a is applicable because you can see these are less than half filled. If these are less than half filled, then we have to apply this rule number 3a, which says, if we have equivalent electrons with less than half filled configuration, then the level with lowest j should lie lowest. Okay, the level with the lowest j lie lowest. Okay, now we will apply all of these rules. We will find that the ground state for this will be 3p naught. Okay, and then 3p1, and then 3p2. Okay. Now because these have the highest multiplicity, so these are the lowest. Okay, one thing. Another thing, for various terms with the given multiplicity, those with largest L will lie lowest. Okay. Now we can see that these two have the same multiplicity. So the largest L is, that is for this D. So we should write D before the. Now we have also arranged this according to the rule 3a. That is, the with lowest j lie lowest. So the lowest j, and then these are highest. So this is the order of increasing energy. Okay. So we see that for a carbon atom, the ground state is, this is the ground state. This is the ground state. Now example 2, let us take the example of a p4 term, which have you know, four equivalent electrons. Now we know that for p2 and p6 minus 2, that is equal to p4, these have the same set of terms. Okay, now the p4 configuration, suppose we have an oxygen atom. For oxygen atom, the electronic configuration is 1s2 and then 2s2 and then 4. Okay, now these are the optically active electrons, these are four equivalent electrons, and these have the same terms. Okay, the same spectral terms. But and we have to find the ground state. Okay, we have found the ground state for, you know, carbon atom, and now we have to find the ground state for the oxygen atom. Now we have the same set of spectral terms. Okay, but there is a difference, that this configuration is more than half filled. This configuration is more than half filled. So all of the rules are same, but this rule 3a is not applicable for this. And which rule is applicable? The rule number 3b. It means if we have equivalent electrons with more than half filled configuration, the level with the largest j should lie lowest. It means we should reverse the order of these p terms. It means the order of terms will be as 3p2 and then 3p1 and then 3p0 and then 1d2 and then 1s0. This is the order. Now you can see that for the carbon atom, the ground state was 3p0, but for the oxygen atom, the ground state is 3p2. Okay, this is the ground state. Okay, so these rules you have to, you know, remember. These rules always, when you want to find the ground state for a particular atom or a particular configuration. Okay, so I hope you understand all these rules, and you can apply it on you know, further more problems. Okay, more if you have more, you know, spectral terms, and you have to find the fine structure levels and the order, you can find by applying these three rules. Okay, I hope you enjoyed the lecture. Okay. And thank you. See you in today's next lecture. Bye-bye.